Hello everyone, welcome back to PGA Chen Design. Today's tutorial, we're gonna use different type of a command to make this cupcake. And also, I will have some like bezel setting on the top as a sprinkle on top of the cupcake. Are you ready? Let's get started. Let's start building this cupcake from the bottom to the top. The first command we are going to use is leaving under the polygon. You have this called star. So I'm going to set it up roughly about 12-ish millimeter in diameter for the bottom. If you look at this, this is really sharp corner. So we want to run the corner, but we don't want to run it one by one. So you have this called fillet corners. I'm going to pick up the curve and set it up the radius. Let me set it up here for 0.15 and let's take a look and see if that is what you want it to have. Okay, let's say this is the one that I wanted to have. I'm going to make a copy with the gumball and hit the Alt key and make this a little bit bigger, just a little bit. This is the going to be taper up. The command we are going to use is using the loft command. We're gonna go from the bottom to the top and make sure they align perfectly. So endpoint to the endpoint, and we hit enter. Then we have something like this. To make it solid, it's simple. We just need to cap it using the command CAP. Then we'll get something like this. So the second part is the creamy part in the middle. I'm going to go to the front view and gonna draw something from here. I am going to turn on the grid snap so it will snap right in the middle and turn it off, and let's go ahead to draw something like this and get it into inside of the foam, right? You can adjust this if this is too high or it's too low, and then you can adjust your curve right here. Okay, now we have this one. We are going to use the command under the surface, and then you have revolve, and you're gonna pick up this one, snapping into the endpoint, holding your shift key, going to the top, and we want to revolve 360 degree, and that's how we get this fitting here. If it is a little bit too big, you can always scale it down, and because we're going inside of the body, so we have enough room to do the bowling, because they are intersect. Okay, so now we have this one. Again, we make it into the solid. We're gonna use the command cap CAP. So now I have two solid together. If you're going to print, you can go ahead to bowling it, but for rendering purpose, you need to all the parts being separate. Okay, so now is the top part. The top part, star command. So let's go to the star, snapping into the zero, and this time we don't need that many. I might just need six of them like this and coming in like that. So I'm going to hide it, the part that we just did, and so we can take a look on this part right here. With this part, we need to have it nice and puffy and round. So again, we're going to use the same command, fitted corners, and then let's set it up a little bit bigger, maybe for one. So I'm going to give myself a reference by giving a line right there. And then I'm going to use the arc tool to snapping into this endpoint and also snapping into this quadrant right there. And let's make a curve roughly about this. All right, so this will be our top cream part, and we are going to use the command is under the surface, and you have rail revolve. We will use this curve profile, and this is the rail, and it's gonna go from this point to this point. Then we will get something like this one. Let's go ahead to cap it, so we'll have something like this, right? So the fun part is you need to kind of twist it. So we are going to use the twist command. We're gonna snapping into the top of that curve and the bottom of the curve, coming back to the top view, and we want to twist. You don't have to twist like dramatically, but I think like 180 degrees should serve the purpose there. So try to play around and see what worked for you. So let's pick up this surface and move it to the top. And this is a steel, this is still a solid. And if it is like not big enough, we can scale it up at this point. And the very last step, we are going to have this stone as a sprinkle on top of it. This is basically a bezel set, and I'm going to put the link right here to my bezel set demo. If you're interested about that, this is the video that you're going to watch. All right, so we can make a copy to this place and kind of tilt it a little bit. Have it sit it in like this, and maybe you can scale it up and down, depends on the size of your charm that is. And then you can go ahead and put a couple more here. I'm just gonna put one just for the demonstration. Don't forget to put your jump ring up there, torus, and that's snapping into the endpoint, holding the shift, coming back like this. The jump ring size is depends on the other size of the jump ring that is going to go through. This is like huge, there's like 3 millimeter in there, so I might need to scale it down just a little bit, something like that. So this will be our cupcake charm today. I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to click the little bell next to the subscription. If you have not subscribed it, please subscribe it and share my video so I can reach more people, and let's have fun with the Rhino 3D model. Thank you, and I will see you next.